În timp, care va fi impactul Brexit?
The impact, I think, is going to be huge. And I think one of the issues we often forget when we talk about Brexit is we forget the UK is divided into, is made up from four nations: England, Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland. It has been driven in many ways, the whole Brexit debate, by the English. There's an English sentiment pushing Brexit. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the longest consequences of all of this could be, at some point in the future, maybe the very near future, mm-hmm. the probable breakup of the United Kingdom itself. So the impact of this is huge. Mm-hmm. The vote in the end was very close. It was 48 against 52. I think that was too close because the country was divided. And I think what's happened ever since is the country remains divided. Mm-hmm. Normally when you have a referendum, the idea is that the two opposing sides will come together. This hasn't happened in this case, and what we've seen is the Labour Party is split and the Conservative Party is split. Already a few members from both the Labour Party and the Conservative Party have left. How will it look like? The harder the Brexit, the more difficult it's going to be to keep the Conservative Party together, keep the Labour Party together, mm-hmm. and to keep the UK together.
Vedem acum că există așa o tendință spre o democrație populară, vorbim aici despre referendumuri, petiții, demonstrații mari, de exemplu cea recentă care a avut loc în Londra, evenimentul pro-European Union, pro-Uniunea Europeană, care vor fi, care sunt avantajele, dar și pericolele, iată, acestor evenimente.
We've seen in recent weeks a huge demonstration in London against Brexit. We've seen also a petition online that is now nearly 6 million people actually wanting to revoke Article 50. Mm-hmm. Do these mean anything? I don't really think they do. In terms of culture, I think it all comes back to political culture. If you get a million people on the streets of Paris protesting against something, then quite often, most occasions, the French government will take that on board. Mm-hmm. The UK system doesn't work like that. So you do these huge demonstrations. Another famous one was the huge demonstration against the Iraq war. That's mm-hmm. meant nothing as well in terms of how Parliament, how government sees it. So people engage in these things, but at the end of the day, they don't really matter. Mm-hmm. The one thing about Brexit to bring in mind is the UK also, in terms of direct democracy, maybe it works for some states. Switzerland is the obvious example, but for other states, it's more problematic. The UK does not have a history in holding referenda. It only ever has had 11. Mm-hmm. 8 of those have been linked to Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland, and devolution. Only 3 have been UK-wide. So holding a referendum is unusual for the UK. Does it work? Well, maybe we could make the case it does work, but maybe in single issues. Is it things like divorce, abortion, mm-hmm. same-sex marriage, things that people come down, they're either black or white, it's pretty straightforward for them. Mm-hmm. The EU was simply too complex an issue to put out to a referendum with a question stating, do you want to remain or do you want to leave? You always have to remember, government thought the UK public would vote to remain. So voting to leave has caused all these problems because they didn't say what leave looked like. And that's why the UK is now in a state of crisis and a constitutional mess.